Hi, my name is Elizabeth Wright, and I'm going to be reading you my paper on my inspiration. Do you have a strong support system? Do you have someone to lean on when times get tough? Luckily for me, I have that. I have my fiancé, Corey. This man is my biggest inspiration and my biggest supporter. He manages to stay calm in the worst of situations. Corey will always find the good in something, and he remains grateful for whatever life throws at us. One memory that stands out for me is March of 2016. This was supposed to be an exciting time, but I knew something was off with me, and I knew it. We were in the waiting room, waiting to be seen by my OBGYN. The room was cold, and I remember being very fidgety in my chair. Fidgety because my mind was running a mile a minute. I couldn't process what was happening, and I didn't want to at that. I remember asking God, please don't let this be true. The hospital was playing what everyone refers to as elevator music. I stared at this one picture for 15 minutes, but what felt like 15 years. I was lost in a daydream. It was an abstract picture with different shades of blues and greens that was directly in front of me. We both just sat in silence. The silence was broken by a nurse calling out my name. I looked at Corey and he smiled. He smiled not because he was happy, but because his smile brings me warmth. His smile lets me know we will be okay. 2 weeks prior to this nightmare of a day, we found out we were pregnant. We were over the moon and extremely scared. We were both so, so young, but completely and utterly in love with one another. I remember freaking out about how will we do this, or do this with a baby. And Corey would just always stay so calm, always reminding me, we got this, we are a team. Corey can make the best out of any situation. I'm very much an anxiety attack waiting to happen. And he knows just what to say and do to bring me back to earth. I inspire to be like that. I inspire to see the world through his eyes, to always do the good and to know we will always get back up. We finally get into the examination room after running several tests. I sat on the examinational table after changing to a paper gown. It started to hit me that there's no going back. This is it. This is what was chosen for me. My doctor walked in and my heart sunk to the floor. She had a look on her face that I've never seen. She looked at me and just said, I'm so sorry. At that point, I lost it. I cried and cried until nothing else came out. A sudden wave of memories rushed over me, memories I'll never get to create because I've lost my child. I've lost someone I've never had the privilege of meeting, but somehow he or she stole my entire heart. I began to blame myself. What if I did this? What if I did this instead of this? I told myself repeatedly. Corey would just hold me and tell me this was never your fault, that there's nothing we could have done. Never did this man blame me or belittle me out of anger. He just loved me harder. Fast forward to now, and we are battling with infertility. We have been trying to expand our little family since April 2017. I have a difficult time conceiving because I've struggled with hypothyroidism since I was 3 and found out in March of 2018 that I also have polycystic ovarian syndrome, which is PCOS for short. Corey has been my biggest supporter through every doctor's appointment every 6 weeks. I have a doctor's appointment every 6 weeks. He's there for me when I have a mental breakdown at 2 a.m. and hugs me until I calm down. He prays for me every time I go back to the examination room and cheers for me when we get amazing news. Corey is such a blessing and an inspiration to so many people around him. If there's one thing that he has taught me about life, is that you should celebrate the small victories because it makes the bigger ones feel so much more important. I slowly stopped taking so much for granted and started loving every moment of my life that I was blessed with. To conclude, this one amazing story should explain why this man has inspired me. He inspires me by just being so grateful for each day. He inspires me to keep my hopes high, whether infertility gets me down or school is overwhelming. No matter the circumstances, he makes the best out of the situation, and I strive to be more optimistic. I know that Corey will always stand behind me with the biggest smile on his face with every roundabout that life throws. Corey, you inspire me each and every single day to get up and be the best me and to never come down too hard on myself. With you, infertility would be that much more bearable.